Hey, good people. Welcome back to my channel. This is your girl, Jessica. I'm back for another video this week. For those of you who are new to the channel, I am a life and transformation coach for women. I help women not only create healthy boundaries so that they can improve their relationships, but also manage conflict and overall help them in every area of their life where they're looking to make changes in order to start living the lives that they truly desire. So with all that being said, let's hop into today's topic. Today, I want to talk to you guys about communication. Now, some will tell you that communication is not one of the top or key elements to a successful and healthy relationship, but I beg to differ. To me, communication is the vital link between you and that other person and actually developing and growing a healthy relationship with one another. You got to be able to communicate. And the sad part is, I see far too often with my clients that the biggest issue that they typically have between them and most of the time their significant other is communication, or failure to communicate, should I say. Believe it or not, people are willing to throw away friendships, throw away relationships, all because of failure to communicate. In the past, I had my fair share of relationships, people that I cut off because I just simply didn't want to communicate. And oftentimes we just think it's so much easier to cut that relationship or that person off, failing to realize that every relationship that you're in is going to involve some form of communication. There's no way that a relationship can move, can prosper, can grow if there's no communication. So what I'm going to be giving you here today is a few tips, a few things that you can start doing in your relationship in order to communicate effectively with your partner. First thing is listening to understand, not to respond. As cliche as that sounds, it couldn't be more accurate. If you're in a relationship and you've come to a place where there's a difficult conversation that needs to be had, there's some sort of challenge or obstacle that's in the way, and you gotta sit down and you have to communicate about how you're feeling, how you're thinking about what's going on, you absolutely have to be willing to listen. If you have to, put yourself in their shoes. This is something that I tell my clients a lot that actually seems to work. For a second, turn off your thoughts. For a second, turn off your feelings and all of your desires and the points that you want to get across to them. Turn all of that off, and for a second, put yourself in their shoes. And now think about all the things that you do want, all the things that you're projecting onto them. Think about how you would feel in their shoes with these demands, with these feelings coming towards you. Put yourself in their shoes for a second and see how it feels and see how you would handle it. See if you would handle it the same way that they are. Oftentimes we're too focused on what our major points are and the things that we want to get out and the things that we want to say, that we often are not listening to really understand, but we're listening to have a response back. You want to strive for a relationship where you can talk to your partner, where you're actually willing to listen to them. They're actually willing to listen to you. And most importantly, you both are willing to accept and take responsibility and take accountability for whatever has happened, whatever has been said, whatever has been done. Another huge thing that you have to be intentional about is when communicating with your partner, setting aside the time to talk to them when the time is right. I say that because oftentimes we want to talk when things are hot and heated and we're both trying to get our points across and nobody's listening to each other. Those are the moments that you need to say, hey, you know what? Things are kind of getting out of hand. I think we both should take, you know, an hour, 2 hours, maybe the rest of the day. You go your way and I go mine for the rest of the day. Let's regroup and let's talk tonight. Let's regroup and let's talk in the morning. That will ensure that the argument doesn't get so heated and get blown so out of proportion to where disrespect happens. Which brings me to my next point. You should be able to discuss and be able to disagree without disrespect. Oftentimes with my clients, when we're talking about different relationship issues that they're having, and I'm trying to help them with managing conflict, that's one of the most common issues within that relationship is disrespect. They feel like their partner, or sometimes themselves, they get so upset that in a moment they hit below the belt, they say things that they don't really mean. They say things that they often regret after they've said it. And I'm going to tell you right now, some things that you'll say, they'll have such a meaning that sorry won't be able to fix. So you really want to be, careful about what you say when you're upset. And hey, I'm human just like the rest of us. So I'm definitely the type of person that I need a moment. I need a moment to collect my thoughts and figure out what's the best way that I want to say what I need to say. I want to make sure that my point gets across without the other person feeling offended or without me attacking that person. And oftentimes in the moment, it's really hard to be transparent and be self-aware, to not do that. So that is why it's so important to talk when the time is right, when you both had time to cool down and you guys are in a better headspace. Set aside that time, sit down and talk about how you're feeling and how they're feeling. And there needs to be, again, a mutual agreement at the end of that. When you and your partner are having a disagreement about something, make it a point to let them finish their thought. Even if you have to ask, even if you have to say, you know, maybe if there's like a slight pause after they've talked, you can say, I wanted to make sure that you were finished, or I wanted to make sure that you didn't have anything else that you wanted to say, then I was going to go ahead and speak. Even if you have to do that, that's absolutely okay. But what I often see is people going back and forth, and nobody can really get their point across and get out what they really want to convey because the other person is talking. Listen to one another. It's important that you don't avoid these types of conversations. I've also seen where in early stages of a relationship, people will tend to not communicate how they're feeling and not communicate when something's wrong. And they do this because in their mind, they're avoiding conflict. They're avoiding having issues so that they can actually say, oh, you know, me and my boyfriend, we don't argue at all. We don't disagree about anything. That's not all in all true. You avoid communicating about how you feel about the disagreements that are between you two. It's not that you don't have them. It's that you're avoiding having those conversations. Again, oftentimes people simply cut off a friend or cut off a relationship instead of facing their issues head on. That's what adults do. And my last point is, no matter what your intentions are, be willing to hold yourself accountable and be willing to apologize for how your partner feels. And this is a huge thing, it seems like, for some people because they want to be right so bad. But when you're having a disagreement with your partner, it shouldn't be about who's right and who's wrong. And it shouldn't be about trying to win some sort of battle or win some sort of point. At the end of the day, you and that person, you guys play on the same team. So maybe your partner sets you down and they're trying to have a conversation about, you know, maybe something you said, maybe something you did that caused them some sort of upset. And maybe you had no intentions of them taking it the way that they did. You had no ill intentions behind what was said or what was done. That's okay. We're all human. Sometimes we get a bit sensitive. Sometimes we're not. Sometimes things just come out the wrong way in a way that we really didn't intend for them to. That's okay. But if your partner is hurt about something that you've said or you've done, that should be enough for you to be willing to take responsibility for that and hold yourself accountable. Hey, that absolutely wasn't my intent. I didn't mean it that way, but I do apologize for how I made you feel. I never do anything like that intentionally. Please accept my apology. I think a lot of people tend to take apologizing to mean that you're weak or to mean that, oh, I lost this. It shouldn't be about that. You should be willing to say you're sorry and be willing to hold yourself accountable for how your partner feels and be willing to let them know, hey, that wasn't my intent. If you sat down and you've watched this video all the way until the end, that means that you are a person that wants to have a happy, healthy relationship. As long as you want that and you're intentional about your actions and what you do and how you communicate with your partner, then there's no way that you and your partner can have a successful relationship. So again, I hope to help someone today. Until next time, you guys be blessed.